Mm-hmm.
We have worship that you run like that.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Mary Magdalene Catholic Community. Thank you for joining us today as we celebrate this third Sunday of Easter. Out of reverence for the Holy Eucharist, please reserve all Facebook comments until after the Mass is ended. Thank you. Our collection today will be taken via online giving. Thank you for your generosity. And our readings and hymns can be found on the church website in the form of a worship aid. Please visit www.st-mm.com/readings-and-hymns. Please rise, and together let us sing All Things New.
Its dreams come true. Do you hear?
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And happy Sunday, the third Sunday of Easter. We celebrate today. The experience of Easter continues in our readings with the Emmaus story of the two disciples who encountered Jesus. Every day we are called and we're invited to encounter him in our struggles of life. We meet him, or he meets us, and he invites us, dialogues with us, and encourages us. So we pray that our experience of him today will truly bring us newness of life and peace and joy. We continue to pray for all those who are experiencing difficulty of illness and of separations because of coronavirus, and we ask for healing for the sick. We pray for those who have died, that the Lord may grant them eternal rest. And we also pray for our doctors, our nurses, our scientists as they find ways to bring an end to this pandemic. Let us acknowledge our sins, and so we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the living Word of God. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the source of everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God.
Let us pray. May your people exalt forever, O God, a renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Thanks be to God. reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you invoke as Father him who judges impartially according to each one's works, conduct yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, "Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?" Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on further. But they urged him, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him. But he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us, while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?" So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
On this third Sunday of Easter, we celebrate the appearance of Jesus to his disciples, some of his disciples, precisely two of them on their way from Jerusalem to the city called Emmaus, 7 miles from Jerusalem. Last Sunday we celebrated, or we read the text of the scriptures that show the doubts of Thomas and his subsequent belief in the resurrection of the Lord 8 days after Easter. But today we're told that very day, the first day of the week, so we went back to like the Easter Sunday. On Easter Sunday, of course, it was a terrible experience for the disciples who had hoped that the Messiah will rise. And in not seeing him in the tomb, an empty tomb, and then also some of them not actually believing what happened, they were traumatized in many ways. There was disappointment and anger and confusion among them. Those were the first feelings of many of these disciples, including these two, Cleopas and his companion, who on that morning just decided to leave Jerusalem for some other place. Why did they have to leave Jerusalem, we may ask? Why did they have to leave the company of the other disciples? Maybe because they were just, as I said earlier, disappointed. They were confused. Maybe they were saying that, well, this man that would have been our hope and is no longer with us has gone. Well, maybe we need to go back to our own businesses and go back to a new life. And so in their confusion, they made this journey. But Jesus accompanied them on that way. So it seems Jesus must have appeared to different people about the same time that morning, or that early Easter morning, because it was that morning also that Mary Magdalene went early to the tomb, and later on Simon and John will go to that same tomb. Along this way, we're not told what time of the day it was, but they said that very day, the first day of the week, that Sunday of Easter, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village. So it may be in the afternoon, about the time when they set out. A 7-mile journey Maybe it might take about 2 hours or maybe a little more, depending on how you walk, or less. For those who are athletes, so they can make it maybe under 10 minutes or 20 minutes or so. But for a leisure walk and a walk of disappointment, as these disciples were, it may have taken them about three or so hours. So we can presume that maybe it was late in the afternoon when they set out, or maybe around 1 or 2 p.m. when they set out. So that getting in the evening, when they got to Emmaus where they were going, it was time for dinner, you know. So we can say that Jesus appeared to so many around this same time on this same day. But what is striking is the fact that Jesus did not allow these disciples to wander alone. He accompanied them on this journey. In their confusion and doubts, Jesus appeared to them and he initiated the conversation with them. And then they asked him questions also, and they didn't recognize him. And so, as it were, they began to, it was an opportunity for them to begin to ask about what is going on, what is the scripture telling them. And Jesus described the scriptures to them and made that fulfillment of the scriptures in his own life. He explained the scriptures to them and said to them, well, the Christ has to suffer and undergo all that he went through so that he can bring salvation to the world. And of course, they didn't recognize him until we're told he broke bread with them. And at table, he offered them the bread and gave thanks to God and then broke it and then gave it to them, and they recognized him. Many times in our lives, in our confusion of experiences, in our doubts, and maybe in our fears, in our disappointments, we are so blinded in our sight that we fail to recognize the presence of God among us. While Jesus was walking with these two, they didn't see him, they didn't recognize him until he calmed them down and revealed himself to them. And God every day tries to reveal himself to us in different ways. And in maybe for those who, for many who are confused at this time and who are still wondering, where is God in the midst of the pandemic that is going on in our world today? For families who have to stay at home and doing their work at home at the same time taking care of their children, somehow the pressure may be a lot. And we may be wondering, why is all this happening? And where is God in the midst of this? But it seems to me that as we think about this and as we ask those questions, we need to ask with some sense of willingness to listen also to the God who is present, even though we may not see him. The disciples, Cleopas and the other, were questioning. They had a lot of questions. They had disappointments. And it appeared they were even hopeless, because they said, we had hoped that this is the one who would do it. Meanwhile, that very one is right there with them, and they didn't see him. But God is always patient with his people, and he will explain to us how and why all of this is happening. But if we have an attentive ears, we will be able to hear him as he speaks to us. And in his coming to us and reminding us of that experiences of life are meant to help us to become closer to him and to be challenged in our faith, then we'll be able to go out and share what we have received. So at the end of the story today, of course, the disciples went back immediately, you know, to Jerusalem to share their experiences with the disciples. The text of this Emmaus story kind of reminds me of the structure of our Mass, our liturgy during Mass. You know, the first part of the Mass is the liturgy of the word, when we read the scriptures, the first reading usually from the Old Testament, the the gospel reading, you know, and of course we have a psalm also that we sing. All of this kind of explains, you know, the Old Testament brings the promise of salvation to us, and then the New Testament gives that fulfillment of that salvation to us. So Jesus explains himself to us in the scriptures in the first part of our liturgy. And then in the second part, the liturgy of the Eucharist, we break bread together. And Jesus did that in this reading today. He broke bread with the disciples, and then he recognized them. And it didn't end there, of course, just as it doesn't end here, when we finish our preparation and our celebration of the Eucharist. At the end of the Mass, the deacon or the priest will say to us, "Go, the Mass is ended." Or proclaim the glory of the Lord with your life. Go in peace, the Mass is ended. That going in peace doesn't mean that everything is over. And in fact, it takes its root from the Word of God in Matthew chapter 28, verse 19, when Jesus commissioned the disciples and says to them, "Go and make disciples of all nations." At the end of Mass, we say, "Go, the Mass is ended." That same message is given to us, just like the two disciples went back to Jerusalem and began to share their story, what they encountered with Jesus. So it is with all of us. When we finish Mass, we are called to go and share our experiences with others. The Jesus we have encountered in the Word of God and in the Eucharist is meant to enlighten us and help us in our lives to go out and share what we have. So the Mass prepares us for evangelization. And even now that we are not able to participate physically in the church for Mass, as we encounter him in one another at home, and even in this virtual Mass that we are listening to, we are still given that commission to go out. And we may not be able to meet people in our workplace at this time. Maybe the person we need to encounter or share this story with is those close to us, those closest to us at home, even now. Because the more we relive the history of our life, the more we share that story of our life with others, with people, with our families, the more we make it our own, the deeper it affects us and it helps us to become better persons. So even in these days, we can still evangelize. We can still proclaim Jesus to others. So we pray today that the Word of God that we have listened to and the bread that we break, even though many of us will not be able to physically receive Jesus, but it comes to us also in a spiritual sense. So we participate in the spiritual communion, longing for that time, of course, when we can gather again and receive Jesus physically. So we pray today that this Word of God we listen to, and His Word and His bread and the wine that we partake in, will bring us healing and grace, and will help the world, you know, to be prepared, you know, for the reception of this Messiah, the one who has come to give Himself to us. In His resurrection, we are alive. And so we pray that His healing power will come upon all of us today, and we will continue to celebrate His love all the days of our lives. Amen.
Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We have walked with the disciples on the way to Emmaus and have listened to the words of Christ. Now we turn to the one who was made known in the breaking of the bread to offer our prayers for those in need.
That the Pope, the bishops, and the priests will walk with all who search for the living God, offering Christ peace and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who lead the nations of the world walk in the ways of justice and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for the gift of human life, may we experience the joy of the resurrection and praise our Lord for every human person. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have contracted coronavirus, we pray for the care and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are easily denied life and opportunity, especially the unborn and the elderly, the poor and persons with disabilities, the ill and the addicted, the illiterate and the foreign-born, will receive justice, compassion, and life in abundance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those whose life's journey is nearing completion will soon behold God's face to face. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Kenny, Alan, Bill, Jan, Virginia, Gilberto, Mabel, Bobby, and Rita, and the community of St. Mary Magdalene for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. You summon us to follow your Son, O God of justice, goodness, and peace. Hear our prayer as we seek his presence in those who suffer. Ease their pain and strengthen them. We ask this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the risen one, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
As a reminder, our collection today will be taken via online giving. Thank you for your generosity. Please join in singing, Now We Remain.
Thank you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Bishop, George, his assistant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Paul, St. Mary Magdalene, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself holy to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Our communion hymn is In the Breaking of the Bread.
In the
to you, our healer and guide, to still our hearts in our time of need and hear our prayer. Heal those who are sick with the coronavirus and protect the elderly and most vulnerable. Give strength to all who tend to our health and wisdom to researchers who work toward a cure. Open our eyes and hearts as you did during Hurricane Harvey, that we may look beyond our immediate needs to care for others who need help. Through the Holy Spirit, guide our leaders to make wise decisions for the welfare of all the people they serve. Grant eternal rest to those who have died from the virus. May Mary, our mother, who has heard our pleas in the storms of our lives, intercede to her Son, that we may find healing and a prompt end to this illness. Mary, Star of the Sea, pray for us. Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, heal us. Amen.
The disciples recognized the Lord Jesus in the breaking of the bread. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a reminder that until we get back to some form of regular life, we will be having exposition of Holy Hour Monday through Friday from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Monday through Friday. And I want to thank all those who have been working very hard to make sure that we keep some minimal running of ministries in our parish during this time. A special commendation to the social ministry who have been collaborating with the Houston Food Bank in supporting and helping many of our community members who lack food during this period. Monday and Wednesday, tomorrow and on Wednesday, we will be able to give out food, to distribute food through the Houston Food Bank to members of our community or all those who come for that. So if you are able to maybe assist us with some volunteer work, you are welcome to call the office or check the website for information about how to make this happen. Usually we will gather about 8 a.m. in order to prepare everything before the distribution. So if you can help us, if you can, please stay at home, stay safe, and continue to pray for an end to this pandemic. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen.
Amen.
May he who by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen.
Amen.
And may you who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is Alleluia, Sing to Jesus.